Hey everyone, Ideogram just released their newest update 2.0. So before that it was 1.0 and now 2.0 is in beta. So I wanna go to Ideogram, I have access, and I'm gonna show you the new updates to it, some new changes, as well as comparing 1.0 to 2.0. We're gonna do some comparison side by side. So let's get into Ideogram right now and see the new 2.0 beta. All right, so here we are on Ideogram, ideogram.ai, and on the Explorer, and it looks pretty similar to what we had before. Here's the difference. So when you click on here, I have 2.0, but originally it was 1.0, so let me show you the differences. So this is 1.0. You can see all these kind of look the same, and this right here says photo, illustration, 3D render, and you're used to that. So let me watch when I change it to 2.0 in beta. So a couple of things have changed right here. The off color palette, off by default, but you can choose a color palette. So let's go here and you can see there's Ember, Fresh, Jungle, some of these, and you can make your own custom color palette if you want. So you can come in here and choose different colors. I'm not gonna do that, but you can make your own. Oh, it already chose it. We're not gonna do that. Let's just do off for now since we're not gonna do it. But yeah, you can have color palettes, make your own kind of vintage color palette would be an interesting one that I would put on here and so on. So turn that off. One of the things that they don't have, and because it's in beta, if you go back to 1.0, you notice this tiling for patterns and stuff. I think they're working on that. That was replaced, not replaced, but you'll notice this isn't here, but what we got instead was the color thing. And I'm sure they're gonna add that in. I mean, I'm not from Ideogram, but I think that's a really cool one. I keep clicking that. I wanna click back to 2.0. This color thing is pretty cool. So what I'm guessing is gonna happen is when they add the grid, they'll probably move everything down. So those things are the only differences on this side. The differences on this side right here, you'll notice I'm 2.0 again. This has changed too. So auto, general, realistic, design, 3D, and anime, which is really interesting. So these are the ones that they kind of want as styles. So different styles. You got just a general style, auto style, which will take from all your prompts. Realistic, right? We got some really cool realistic ones here already. And I believe some of these are 1.0, but they look realistic. It's a very popular one. Design is the one that I'm gonna use for t-shirt designs. 3D is self-explanatory. Things pop out, like more like this one right here is more of a 3D. And anime, which is a really popular one for like kawaii stuff or anime looking manga kind of stuff. All right, another thing that I like is right here, this is not new, but it's rising, top hour, top week, but you can also search on these things. So I can search on design, right? These are all design. And you can see that a lot of them are t-shirt designs, but you can go a step further and search t-shirt. So I'm gonna type in t-shirt. And anybody that put in the prompt t-shirt, it's gonna show here as well as a design. So t-shirt design, take a look at these. Right? And these, a lot of these were made with just 1.0. So if I click on here, we can see Ideogram 1.0. What I'm gonna do today in this video is take this same prompt and see what the difference is between this and 2.0. So we're gonna just use the same prompt. I'm gonna hit copy right there. I'll go back, hit describe, go V here, Command V. So same prompt here. And we're using 2.0 and let's see if it works any better. It's already great. Let's see what it is with 2.0. Now you'll notice there's Explore and My Pages. I think that's similar for what it was before. So that's where it's gonna go. I'm gonna go to My Images. Did I say My Pages? I meant My Images. And you're gonna see that it's working here. And it's gonna take that prompt, the unicorn design for kids. Look at that. Pretty cool, right? I really like this one. It has the script font that just looks really cool. We got this one here, this one, and this one. So some nice variation of fonts, but all of them are spelled correctly, which is really nice. So my favorite one is this one. We're gonna compare that to the other one. I'll put the two right here. What do you think about that? I think I like the cursive on this one. So they both work great for t-shirts, and you would just knock it out and looks like a great t-shirt design. Let's try another one, a couple more maybe. So I'm going to go back to my search with design and t-shirt. And let's try one that's mostly text instead of having a graphic. So like this one, this would be cool. I don't know how you would improve on this one because it's pretty good. I guess that T right there could be better. And let's see, make sure that's a 1.0. So this is a fair one. Wow, they got prompt and magic prompt. I'm gonna try and copy the magic prompt this time. And I'm gonna go here and Command V. So there's that magic prompt. I'm gonna make sure I hit design. And let's make sure we're on two. I know we're on two because we have the color palette. So let's hit it. Now again, I'm gonna go to my images and we're just gonna wait. Notice how fast it is too. It's almost done, 40%, 50%. So 2.0 is still pretty quick, even though it's the later version. It's pretty speedy, so almost there. This is real time. I didn't make it any faster. Oh wow, cool. Okay, so you'll notice that it's similar, but it didn't do the thing on the end with the T. And this one, they're all, let's check spelling. So coffee and friends make the perfect blend. Okay, coffee. This F is kind of hard to read, but that's just the font. And friends make the perfect blend. Okay, coffee and friends make the perfect blend. Great. Coffee and friends make the, this one right here is kind of weird, but that's fine. But they all read well. I think, like, I like this one, and it's really similar to the one we just saw. So probably because of the magic prompt, the typography is whimsical, so it kind of copied. And what I liked about it is it fixed that T right here at the end on perfect, and it kind of highlighted perfect, which was interesting, not on the other one. Yeah, the other one had that issue with the T, and the F wasn't that great, but I think it did even just slightly better, even though the both are pretty good. I think the new one is slightly better. Okay, so we're back here. Let's try something different. All right, this could be a fun one. This is Be Kind. Kind of has some issues here with the, I think is not a huge issue, but kind of the coloring inside the B, the pattern in here. The B is pretty good. Let's see how much it would improve if I copied this. I'm gonna paste it here. I'm gonna use design. I'm gonna make one by one and no color palette. And let's generate, see what happens. Now, this one is a very simple prompt. You saw it's not very many words, just be kind, t-shirt design. In fact, I spelled design wrong. Whoops, I didn't even catch that. But I do have design on there, so let's see what it does. Okay. And I didn't say to add a B to it, which I probably should, but pretty cool. So very different t-shirt design. Probably should have spelled t-shirt design well, but this is kind of neat. Be kind. It did so many great variation of it. Doesn't look anything like the other one, but it's very clear. And I think it has more of a kitty whimsical look. This one's kind of cool right here. So this one's gonna be the one I compare it to. Very different, hard to compare, but I think this one is a lot easier to cut out. It's just more solid and could work well on a white background. Now I probably would say on a black background. Let's see what would happen. And let's change this to design and with a B, just to make sure we have a B. Okay. Let's see if this makes any different and go. So this one I did speed it up a little bit, but it's still working here. I wanted to see what would happen. Let's see on a black background because the first one was on a black background and it had a B. Yeah, kind of cool. Different here. I kind of like the big B on the first one, but this is a nice take on some other one. This one doesn't actually have a B. But really cool. I like the changes to the, I think the typography is so much stronger in 2.0, at least for the most part. Like this one's kind of hard, but look how nice and easy to read some of these typography. And so far, it hasn't made any errors in typography or words, right? It all spelled, it's my birthday, birthday. I think that was one of the big things in 2.0. Okay, just one last test. I'm very curious about this anime one, and you can see some examples of anime. So I don't think it means kawaii. I think it means more this kind of anime stuff. In fact, let's look what the other ones are. So all, here's all. There's some really cool stuff here. And then realistic. Yes, they look a lot more, some of them look really realistic, like looks like a bird. Design, so this is the one we like as t-shirt designers, I think we would use design, so you can see a lot of these. Not all of them are t-shirt designs, but a lot of these are perfect for t-shirt designs, you better believe it. 3D, so yeah, some nice 3D lettering. Kind of hard to put these on a t-shirt, but for a poster, I think these would do really well. And anime, what a cool style here. I don't know if you can do anime for a t-shirt design. Let's see what would happen if I type it in. I'm gonna do a cute kawaii corgi eating ramen. Let's try that again. For a t-shirt design, let's do that with a black background. All right, and let's make sure it's anime, so maybe it gets that style, and hit generate. Now, I'm not exactly sure what it's gonna do because these are kind of anime style, but I asked for kawaii style, so I don't know if there's gonna be some disconnect there. I think it's gonna be more this style with it. I don't see any with like a black background. Maybe that one is, so let's go to my images and see what it's coming up with. Oh! Kind of cool. So this is a funny way to do it. Yeah, not my favorite out of it. I don't think it can do kawaii very well because we're probably messing it up by doing a kawaii and anime together. So it's like, this is kind of anime right here. So this one, I think I kind of messed it up by having the anime style. I wonder if we do the same one, but instead of anime, we'll just do design. Right, and hit generate. So let's see the difference between anime, which is some of these is like a anime cartoon with the big eyes and stuff. So let's see if it pulls in the kind of the kawaii stuff with it in design. So, and I think design is usually what we're gonna, yeah, see, so design is what we want for t-shirt designs. I think these are a lot better than this. I'd rather be ramen with my corgi. That's funny. Yeah, some really cool one. I like this one the best right here. So pretty cool. All right, so those are the different changes. You can come in here and try it out. Let me tell you about one thing. You may not know, Ideogram is free, but there are some paid versions. So I'm gonna come in here and go to manage subscription here. And you can see, you got the community gallery and stuff, but I believe to use everything that I showed, you'll have to have one of these paid versions. And the basic one is $7 a month. If you haven't signed up for Ideogram yet and want to sign up, I'll put a link, an affiliate link in my description there. And with that, you'll get 100 more priority prompts a month. So whether you're doing basic or plus or pro, it's gonna add 100 more priority prompts per month. So that's a little bonus if you haven't had this and you want to try it. You don't have to, but it's there. And yeah, it works for anybody that's new here that doesn't have a subscription yet. I think the difference between this is it's a lot slower if you don't have it, and you don't have a lot of these things like a upscale and advanced settings and the tile, which we saw in 1.0, which is really cool. So figure out which one's best for you. Of course, you can always try it for free and learn and try it out. So there you go. Hopefully that was really helpful for you, so you can see the difference between 2.0 and 1.0. I think 2.0, just this beta, I know they're gonna get out of beta and add more things, but just the beta is pretty cool. You saw the text. I really love how the fonts and the text are a lot more readable, and that design style works really well for t-shirts. You can see by searching for design, you can get a lot of ideas what it can do, as well as get some good prompts and try it out. So Hopefully this tutorial is really helpful for you. You can go and try it out. I think everybody has the beta now, so go try it out. Go to Ideogram and try out all the different things. Have fun with it. Let me know in the comments what you think about the 2.0 release and which ones you thought were better. And if you want to see more Ideogram videos, I'll put my latest one right here so you can watch that as well. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.